We are ready for our next session. We have Janelle and AJ with us here from Grab, and they're going to tell us about their work in Southeast Asia with Grab, where they started really from scratch building the whole OpenStreetMap into Grab. So very curious to see where you are at now, from where you started and from where you are at now. I think it's an interesting journey.
Hi guys, can you hear me well? I'm sorry about my voice. I think the weather has not been kind to me. But hi, I'm Ajay, and I lead the GeoMap operations team at Grab. I'm joined by Janelle and our two amazing community people are going to join us as well in a bit. Just to kick proceedings off, can you guys guess where this is? Any guesses? All these pictures from where are they? Okay, Asia, where in Asia? Any city, any country? Okay, Malaysia, Indonesia, any city? Okay, awesome. This is from beautiful Bali, that's in Indonesia. I'm sure most of you have heard of Bali. Okay, can you guys guess where this is? Okay, Jakarta, amazing guess. Okay, any other guesses? Okay, awesome. So this is from Jakarta, Manila, Philippines. I mean, this is across the world as well. So as you can see, there are two very amazing, contrasting things about Southeast Asia. We just wanted to kick it off with that. And just give you a little bit of perspective of who we are, what we do initially, then Janelle takes over to make, just a little bit more about what we do with OSM and why we love it so much. So Southeast Asia is technically the third most populous country in the world, if you look at it that way. We are about 640 plus million people across 11 countries, and Grab operates in 8 out of the 11 countries. So why did we start Grab, right? So Grab started about 7 years back with these three missions in mind. So we definitely wanted to make transportation for Southeast Asia safer. As we started, I mean, our co-founder always tells us a story, like she would take a cab in Malaysia at 11 p.m. after her work at McKinsey, and then she would actually call her mom and just stay on the phone to make sure that something doesn't happen on the way in a taxi. So this was one of the key motivations why Anthony and Link started Grab. A second, we also wanted to make sure that we build for the local needs. As you can see, 11 countries, hundreds of cities, every country is different culture, to make sure that we hyper-localize for the region. The third most important reason is also accessibility for all. At one point, taxi or ride-hailing in our region was considered a luxury. So our key goal was to make sure that we truly democratize transportation. Okay, where are we today? So in the last 7 years, our journey has been pretty amazing, I would say. We are one of the largest consumer applications in the region with over 170 million people using it. So we are the number one transportation platform in the region. We are also the number one fintech platform, and we also are one of the fastest growing regional food delivery services across Southeast Asia. In true sense, we call ourselves the super app of the region. But were we the super app to begin with? No. We had really humble beginnings. As you can see, in 2014, we were predominantly a transportation application. And as we evolved in the course, today we are where we are. And as our head of product likes to say, he joined in 2016 and the app has evolved to becoming a super app. How many of you know what a super app is in this room? Okay, one. Any idea of what a super application is? Okay, so basically, like when we say it is the number one consumer choice super app, this is how our app looks today, right? So we have a horizontal integration of services, and we also have something called Grab Platform, where other players can come and plug their services into our customer application. If you see our app, not only does transport today, we have two-wheeler, we have food, grocery delivery, we have payments, and we also have multimodal. So it's one app for like a lot of use cases that generally you would use different applications for. It's a very Eastern concept. I think China predominantly started the whole era of super applications, but Grab is truly one of the biggest super apps in the region that we operate in. And just proceeding This is like another fun annotation of what all we do at Grab and how it is so different in every country. We also have ferries in some places where like there's no cars. We also have something called tuk-tuks that are three-wheelers. That is very, very Asian concept again. And we also have bikes. We have autos like in India. But we don't operate in India, but it's similar in Myanmar. And we also do an array of food delivery services using our PMDs. Now, to do all of this, or have map data that is accurate, that's fresh, and also has amazing coverage across all the cities we operate in. And to talk more and how we do it and how we use OSM, I'm going to give it over to Jinal.
Is it, am I audible? Right. So you're, yeah, 1 second. Is there a way to connect to the...
Can someone from the tech team come and help with the sound?
It's okay?
Yeah.
Okay. That our team has been doing across Southeast Asia and some of these cities. Yes, thank you. So I think something that I said, which Ajay mentioned, that there are a bunch of services and everything that use OpenStreetMap, and here are a few of these examples. We use it for the electronic routing pricing, the road pricing, which is ERP, then there's roads, then there's also street level imagery and in our app as well. And so, yeah, these are the places where OpenStreetMap supports us. So Grab, until now, the data team that we've mentioned has added close to 200,000 kilometers of roads in OpenStreetMap in Southeast Asia, and over 55,000 buildings. So I think you must be wondering how this entire thing works, and that's what I'm here to explain. So we get, as you said, we have almost around 200,000 map issues that are reported through our drivers, passengers, community, and the traces, and our team, which is divided into these three aspects. We have the remote map operations teams, which I think a lot of you guys are aware of. And then we have our local map operations teams, which through the different slides, you'll actually see them, who they are. And they are in all the 8 countries that we operate in, who have local knowledge, information, and everything that they need to know about that particular city that they are in, thus making it much more localized and the hyper-local experience that we are trying to give. And then we have our field map operations team. And then why is SEA special? So I think when Ajay showed us about Bali and the places, they look really beautiful, and then we see congestion and traffic. What makes it different? Like, we have multiple ways in which we can have roads, and the conventions vary from place to place. The community has multiple communication channels, and we have younger and vibrant OSM communities that needs mentoring and that needs to grow. So can you guess this sign? Anyone? Which sign is it? I know it's a little dark, but any idea? It's like an exclamatory mark. Anyone knows what it is? There is no OSM Wiki documentation, just for the information. I'm sorry? Some danger ahead. Click again. So it's basically a warning sign, which usually is followed before like a supplementary sign. And this is just one of such cases. There could be many, but it's a very interesting case. So can anyone tell me what is interesting about this one? So there is a no right turn, but the signal says that you can go right. How do you map this? So this is one of such case. And can you go one slide back? Thanks, Ajay. So this one, I think it should be a living street according to the wiki conventions, but motorbikes do travel from here. So do we map this as living streets or do we have another convention? Because it's not big enough for a car to travel, but it's not small enough for people to like walk. So, and then the next one is a road which does not have a marking. It has multiple lanes. So should we map this as a single lane, which does not like go with the width that it's supposed to go? Or should we map this as two lanes, but we're not sure if it's conventions? So these are a few of these dilemmas that our team, and in general that we all go through when we are mapping. And this is just very few. There are huge cases, like use cases that we can share later on. And how do we work through this? So we have this amazing community in Southeast Asia, and we are there on the mailing list. We have forums, we have Telegram, which is very, very well used in Southeast Asia, and very active community members out there who are always on there to help us and figure out if there are things that are not working out. And we also meet them in person. So our team travels across. If there are things that we need to sit, we decide, we work together on workflows, we see what works in that particular region, because as we know, the community knows the region better than we do. So that's the thing. And now I'd like to request Eugene, who is also someone who's been guiding us throughout. He's from the Philippines community, to tell how we are working with them.
So I'm Eugene from the Philippines, and basically we're trying to work with the Philippine MapOps team of Grab. So in order to work with them to make sure that they're editing properly and adhering to the local community standards. So one thing that we've done so far is have a mapathon to meet their team. And this October we'll be having a training session with them, with their maps team, so that they'll be able to map properly in the Philippines, adhering to, again, to the local community standards.
Thanks so much, Eugene. And then we also work in collaboration with like Mapillary and OpenStreetCam. We collect these images and give it back to the community. This is not just useful for us, but also to the community to map as well as during disasters, because this is super helpful as a point of reference. And then comes to community programs. So I think, as I said, all of these folks who are using our app or the ones who are in the community form a huge community and very important to Grab. And we have our passengers who really love quick map updates. And this is our driver community. So he's talking about how he gave us a feedback on how things are working, and that changed the way he was operating. And he's speaking in Bahasa, but you can see the conversation and how he was happy that that is actually changing the way he's operating. And then, so as I said, that there are so many drivers, and this is like the huge community. This is a town hall in Indonesia that happened a while back, and they form a huge community, and we work with them. Not just like they are sort of the first responders when it comes to like the when there are natural disasters and everything. So we work closely with them, and they are really important to us. And then, as I said, we have the map operations team, I think, which Eugene mentioned and everything, and they are all across the Southeast Asia. So they help us get, they are the faces for the community and us, and we work with them to conduct all these events, mapathons, and everything that's going on the ground and within Grab. And something which is really important is GeoStars. I think we have the existing community, but something that we need to leverage on is the new generation or the kids from the university. So we are working on this particular program called GeoStars, which basically works in this similar way. We have these phases. We have universities. We try to reach out to them, know more about what they are working on and how we can teach them about OpenStreetMap, the geospatial world, through leadership and training. And we have a bunch of workshops that we teach. We teach them, and then they lead these workshops and grow the community. So it's basically training the trainers and growing the community. And right now we have close to 15 universities on board across Southeast Asia. So they are in Philippines, Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, and all of these are running these programs in as a part of curriculum as well as a separate program which the students can attend. And these are the Geostars graduates so far. And hopefully next time we'll have a bigger picture and a bigger frame that we can share with all of you guys. And then we just not stop there. We host, our offices host a lot of these events, and we call it, thank God, it's Map Day. So not limited to one of them, but to most of these days. So we pick up and we have really fun mapping parties where we pick an attribute and map, or we teach them something new, or we learn something new from the folks who are veterans in OpenStreetMap. And then mapathons with kids. This was something which really touched my heart when I attended, where we have parents from different communities who actually got to know about maps, and they bring their kids. So there's like a group which attends all of our events, and they love it because this is something which they don't see in school, but they are fascinated and they want to learn more about maps. And now their kids are actually like developing programs and things where they can use this data and go ahead. So it is a great thing for us. And we also interact with the driver's kids. So we call them for sessions. We teach them fun activities of maps. So we don't really get them mapping, but we teach them the basics of mapping, which will be good enough for them to like get excited and step into the world of OpenStreetMap. And I think mapping parties are fun, but always I think there's an underlying cause that we all really work towards, and one is mapping for inclusivity. So we have a few hundreds of our drivers who are specially abled, and these mapping accessible wheelchair, accessible places, and all around that is something which is super vital to us. And we also encourage community, and we do training sessions for not just us, but the community, to make this an inclusive thing, and it's open so people can use it. And there are a lot of other applications who are using this data such that it's making their lives easy. And I think we all know Southeast Asia is a zone for natural disasters. Indonesia is on volcanoes, and we can't stop them, but we can be prepared for them. And thus we have and we just do not limit our teams to like Southeast Asia, but we also like contribute to like different humanitarian efforts that are going around. Like one such example is the Kerala floods that happened last year, where our team jumped in and helped mapping and worked with the team on other aspects. So I'd like to invite, since I always have mentioned hot OpenStreetMap Indonesia, I'd like to invite Yantisa to tell more about that.
Thank you, Gina. Okay, so this is like the mapathon that we've conducted in the past several years ago, that this is how the participant is really eager to understand more about how they can map their own community, and then how in a very short amount of time they can contribute a substantial amount of data, and the data surely all be validated before they're entered into OpenStreetMap. Thank you, Ajay. And this is the second one on how it really helps the disaster management purpose, that the Grab driver was being trained on how to use the smartphone app that can easily collect the data for emergency response. This is the case during Mount Agung volcano eruption, that the Grab driver was trained in less than a day, and then the next day they are collecting all the IDP cam and then the internally displaced population cam, as well as the logistic requirement for that cam, like how many women, how many children, and then what is required, like how many rice and all basic staple. And then the Grab driver sent it the data directly to the smartphone app, and then it was received by the National Disaster Management Agency to provide a proper response to this disaster.
So these are a few of the activities that our team is conducting, and I just wanted to end it with this note. Driver's kids, and we just don't actually teach mapping, but we have activities and questions, so we know that they're learning about it. Grab Philippines. This is Malaysia. and this is our team. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. It's a wonderful video with all these smiley faces and people eager to map. So thanks a lot for your talk. Who has questions for this team? There, I see a question. Yeah.
So I was wondering why you at Grab contribute to the OpenStreetMaps, because a lot of companies usually have their private data sets based on OpenStreetMaps. And yeah. Okay, my question is, why do you at the company Grab contribute to OpenStreetMaps instead of just having a private data set like a lot of companies do?
Why OpenStreetMap? Okay, just let me know if I got your question right. So you mean that why are we contributing to OpenStreetMap and not having our own data set?
Yes, that's correct.
You wanna take this,
Ajay? Yeah, so I think there are a couple of, there are some business related aspects, also the whole community related aspects. So we feel mapping is the biggest crowdsourcing platform you can ever do. And we have the biggest community of people plus drivers. So we feel this is the best way to do it because there's an ecosystem around it, there is tools, processes, there's also a lot more that we can get from the community and contribute back than having our own map layer. That is the biggest primary reason. Two is also, if you look at it purely as a technology or a business, right? We feel that our region requires a lot more contribution. It's because the region has not been worked on in a long time because like we are currently the biggest company there and we rely on geolocation all the time. So we feel that is another important element of actually giving back to the community. So these are the two key reasons why we've stuck, or rather like we love OSM, and we feel that there's an inherent interest. Like if you see, we have Philippines and Indonesia HOD working with us. And so we feel we can actually build a beautiful ecosystem rather than doing everything privately. And that's part reason why we have said we are a very partnerships driven company. Like we're happy to work with anybody who wants to come work with us. We will host events, do mapathons, anything. But this is primarily why we have chosen OSM.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Good question. Another question? Yeah, there's one.
Hi, I'm Ilya from Russia. Well, I can stand, sorry. So, great presentation, thank you. I always, always like when big companies promote OpenStreetMap and find new mappers. But together, you have shown so many slides, so many photos with like stadiums full of great people, and that's probably somehow related to maps. And the picture your slides are painting is a bit scary. Like OpenStreetMap in your region is becoming grab map. Like, do you have a community mappers not affiliated with grab, and how's your relation to them?
I'll take one part of the question, generally we'll take the other part. So I think it looks like that because we give everybody this green, bright green t-shirt. There's nothing to say that they all work for Grab. They're actually, like our teams are pretty small. The only slides that we see every country, we have like 8 to 10 who are the local community. But I think for us, it's more about working with Marcian and Eugene and the teams there. We don't do any like Grab's own mapping events as such. We always try and collaborate with HOT locally to do these events. But we also evangelize OSM on our own to children, driver's kids, Geostars. All of that is where we follow the same protocols, same everything. It's just that we give them those t-shirts because they look nice. And everybody loves Grab t-shirts so in the region. So students particularly get really excited when we go on campus, we give them swag, we give them sticker. So that's the more softer element to it. But otherwise, I don't think there's anything else unless.
No, and I think, as you said, it looks that it is synonymous with what OpenStreetMap is doing, but we try, and I mean, even the Geostar program, we'll soon be making all of this public, so it's going to be used by not just us, but everyone else, but we're teaching them about OpenStreetMap. The whole idea behind all of these programs is to make folks in Southeast Asia more aware of what geospatial world is,
yes.
how the data is, and what are the different things that we can do with it, and encourage even the research students. So like the program that I'm running in NUS has the postgrad students who are working on research projects. So like introducing them to this beautiful data set explores a lot of more opportunities which otherwise is impossible. Go for it, Ajay.
No, so I would also say that since we are, as I said, currently the biggest consumer-facing company that uses so much geolocation, so we are just in the forefront of actually going and enabling these communities across, because we want people to understand that geo and mapping is not a one company, one person, one effort. It's a very community-driven effort together. That is what we are trying to evangelize in any of these events. We teach them basically the techniques of how to use ID, how to use JOSM, what are the policies, you know, what is a tertiary road, primary road. So we just cover the basics, and we keep a very open comms channel with them that if they ever want to reach out, they can reach out to us.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for the question, Elio.
thanks a lot. We are at the end of the session, so we say give them a big applause.